So the day that everyone seems to be waiting for is finally here. AMD is officially launching their RX 5000 series GPUs, and boy, has it been an interesting few weeks. You see, this all started at E3 when AMD showed off their shiny new Navi GPUs, particularly the RX 5000 series, and then Team Green had to respond with their RTX supercards that sort of set a benchmark as to what these cards are kind of competing with. Just a couple of days ago before this launch, AMD threw an interesting curveball at us with price cuts on these new GPUs at launch. This is just a typical AMD thing. I'm not really surprised. But now, after more than a year of rumors, we can finally talk about how the RX 5700 XT and the 5700 perform in benchmarks. Are they actually worth buying over the RTX supercards that Team Green launched just last week? To be honest with you, a lot of this video had to be redone just because of AMD's new lower prices on these graphics cards. So let's talk about that right after a quick word from our sponsor. Looking for a solid board to pair your 9th-gen CPU? The ASRock Z390 Tai Chi gets it right with robust VRM designs for extreme overclocking, a 12-phase power design for smooth power delivery, dual-band Wi-Fi, 3 M.2 slots, and reinforced PCI connectors. Learn more about it down below. All right, so if you want a bit more information about these new GPUs, specifically with the architecture, you can actually check out our explain video right over here. But in this video, I'm going to be focusing a lot more on the performance benchmarks and not really get into the other stuff. And also, since a lot of you guys have been asking, I'll make sure to leave timestamps in the description down below. So let's do a quick spec recap on both of these new GPUs. So they're based off the Navi 10 core and use a 7-nanometer manufacturing process. The RX 5700 XT will have 2560 stream processors, 8 GB of GDDR6 memory with 448 GB per second of bandwidth, a board power of 225 watts, and now a lower price of $400 US. Its base and game frequencies are 1605 MHz and 1755 MHz, respectively. The RX 5700 gets cut down to a little over 2000 stream processors and lower frequencies, which lowers board power to about 180 watts. It still gets 8 GB of GDDR6 memory and a new price of $350 US. Now, about that new pricing, it's really made things interesting because after seeing how NVIDIA's RTX supercards perform, I think AMD might have come to a realization that they've priced these new GPUs a little too high, especially if you consider when those new RTX supercards come with 2 free games. So this is how things line up right now. The RX 5700 XT is a whole $100 cheaper than the RTX 2070 Super, making it the exact same price as the RTX 2060 Super. The RX 5700's price is about the same as the RTX 2060. Another thing a lot of people have brought up is how used GTX 1080 Ti cards cost around $350 to $400 these days. I'd be a bit worried of getting one that's been abused in countless hours of cryptocurrency mining, but yeah, that's another option if you're willing to take the risk. Let's take a look at the cards to see what you're getting, since at launch there won't be any custom designs, which is unfortunate. Those will be available to buy a month or more afterwards. Starting with the 5700 XT, it's one good looking graphics card with a swooping heatsink shroud that almost looks dented, but that design is supposed to increase internal airflow and lower the amount of noise too. Flipping the card around, there's a full coverage backplate that uses the same cool rib design as the top shroud, but this time it's broken up by a smooth area along with a red strip. One of our concerns with these blower style cards is that they're always fighting for airflow, but the RX 5700 XT's back edge is actually pretty open, which should increase the amount of air it can draw in. But personally, my favorite angle of this card is from the edge, which has the glowing Radeon logo. It looks clean and really well done, and that's where the 8 plus 6-pin power connectors are. For output, AMD has kept it pretty simple with 3 DisplayPort 1.4B connectors and a single HDMI 2.0B on both cards. Now, by comparison to the XT, the RX 5700 is almost boring. Basically, the entire shroud is a uniform gray with red Radeon text and a small amount of silver around the fan. Honestly, I think AMD should have added a backplate here, since the RTX 2060 and the RTX 2060 Super Founders Editions have cool looking backplates. This just looks cheap in my opinion. Another big concern is that AMD's designers chose to close the back edge, which kills airflow. This is just another odd decision, since adding a secondary intake area should have been a no-brainer. Wrapping things up, the power connectors are identical to the 5700 XT with an 8 plus 6-pin layout. Now, looking at these cards, it's pretty easy to be concerned about acoustic performance, especially since Blower style coolers are always louder than downdraft coolers like these. So let's take a listen to all of these GPUs at load, since during idle scenarios, all of them are super quiet. So it's obvious that the RX cards are a lot louder than the RTX Super Series, but this is all fan noise. Luckily, there wasn't any coil whine on the AMD GPUs, which is certainly good news, but I do want to mention that the coil whine on the RTX 2060 Super certainly did influence its results, which is just too bad. I also want to quickly look at power consumption, because AMD has made a lot of progress with their 7-nanometer manufacturing process, but is it enough? So this is actually pretty interesting, since it looks like the 5700 series has nearly closed the gap, but that isn't necessarily good news. Remember, Nvidia is still on 12 nanometer, and it took a super efficient 7-nanometer process for AMD to draw even. At least this time, anyone who buys a Radeon card won't have to worry about super high power draw. So I think it's time to talk about how these cards stack up, but I'm gonna start things a little bit differently this time, starting with the overall performance benchmark list. And if you want to know how we acquired those numbers, the individual game performance will follow right afterwards. So this is what things look like after a dozen of games being tested, and you can actually see why AMD reduced their prices. You'll see in the next few minutes that Navi's performance is very strong against Nvidia's RTX 2070 and the 2060, but the Super Series is very different. In raw numbers, the RX 5700 XT loses by about 12% overall to the RTX 2070 Super, and the RX 5700 sits right in between the RTX 2060 and the RTX 2060 Super. There's really nothing to complain about here, since all of these are really strong numbers. But hold on, when it comes to raw value, AMD actually leads by a pretty big margin. The RX 5700 XT's new $400 price causes it to just dominate the $500 RTX 2070 Super. Even the RX 5700 looks pretty good against the RTX 2060 Super. I mean, it doesn't offer more performance, but it does cost a whole $50 less, while also beating the vanilla RTX 2060 by about 7%. Like I said in the RTX Super review, the pricing of these two RTX 2060 cards is just way too high right now. Also guys, do keep in mind that the GTX 1080 Ti provides almost similar performance to the RTX 2080, so if you can find that GPU for $400 or less, it would blow any of these cards right out of the water. But as I mentioned earlier, be aware of the mining cards in the used market. So where does this leave the RX 5700 XT and the RX 5700? Well, other than the average frame rates I already mentioned during testing, we also noticed that their lower 1% frame rates were all over the place. In some games like Battlefield 5, they easily beat the Nvidia cards, but in some really popular titles like Fortnite, PUBG, and Total War, they really lagged pretty far behind. So obviously, consistency is still an issue for AMD. So the big question is whether or not if you should buy the RX 5700 series over GeForce RTX. And the answer to that really depends on what you think of Nvidia's features like ray tracing, DLSS, and content adaptive shading. You see, if you only care about standard game rendering, the RX 5700 XT is a better buy than the RTX 2070 Super. And the same can be said about the RX 5700 versus the RTX 2060 Super. But this is important. You can't just ignore what Nvidia has to offer, especially since a lot of these games are including ray tracing elements and performance is improving, so that does count for something. So there you guys have it, and I certainly think AMD's on the right track. It's just that they have a lot of catching up to do, but I really want to know your thoughts about all of this. Do you still think these cards are too expensive, or is there one that you look into? Are there any other games or tests that you'd like us to run? Definitely let us know in the comments down below. I'm Ivor with hardwarecanucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe for some cool content coming in the pipeline. I'm signing off, and I'll see you guys in the next one.